Hello, my dear children. Today we will discuss isosceles triangle theorem. Now remember, you need not learn the theorem by heart, but you should know the property. Okay, so according to the reduced pattern, this theorem will not come for your exam, but you should know the property. Property is there for solving the sums, and same thing will be there for your 10th standard also. So this thing you should learn, you should know what is isosceles triangle theorem. Now, in an isosceles triangle means if two sides of a triangle are congruent, that triangle is called as isosceles triangle. So, this is an isosceles triangle where side AB is congruent to side AC. So, I have written that AB congruent to AC. Now, here, if you have an isosceles triangle, according to the property, if two sides of a triangle are congruent, then the angle opposite to them are also congruent. AB is congruent to AC, then the angles opposite to the congruent sides, that is AB's opposite angle is angle C, AC's opposite angle is angle B. So we have to prove that angle ACB congruent to angle ABC. So to prove angle ABC congruent to angle ACB. For that, we will do a construction. What construction? We will draw an angle bisector for the third angle. That is, for angle BAC, we will draw an angle bisector. So, let AF be the angle bisector. So, ray AF or segment AF is the angle bisector of angle BAC. So, now angle BAC is divided into two equal parts, angle BAF and angle CAF. Now, you will take these two triangles and prove them congruent. In triangle BAF and triangle CAF, as you can see, AB is congruent to AC given. Then, BAF congruent to CAF construction, and we have the common side AF congruent to AF. So, both the triangles are congruent by SAS test. So, I can write, therefore, triangle BAF congruent to triangle CAF by SAS test of congruence. So, if both the triangles are congruent, then obviously, I can say that angle ABF is congruent to angle ACF, CACT. Correct or not? We wanted to prove these two congruent, no? We got these two triangles congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then I can say that, therefore, angle ABF congruent to angle ABF, so ACF. Congruent to ACF, CACT, corresponding angles of congruent triangles. So, I got this. So, ABF congruent to ACF by CACT. And what is this ABF and ACF? If I extend it, it will be, therefore, ABF can be written as angle ABC congruent to angle ACF can be written as angle ACB. Reason B dash F dash C betweenness property. Okay. So, what we wanted to prove? We wanted to prove these two angles are congruent. We got it by SAS test of congruence and by taking CACT. So simple. I don't know why it was cancelled. Okay. So, you have to remember the property. If two sides are congruent, then the angles opposite to them will be congruent. Similarly, the converse. In converse, they will give you a triangle. Converse of isosceles triangle theorem means if you have a triangle, suppose let us take it as triangle DEF. In isosceles triangle theorem, they gave the sides congruent. Here, ulta, they will say that angle DEF is congruent to angle DFE. So, if two angles in a triangle are congruent, then the sides opposite to them are also congruent. So, side opposite to DEF is side DF. Side opposite to angle DFE is DE. So, we have to prove that side DE congruent to DF. Same way, you will draw an angle bisector for this angle. You will take these two triangles and you will prove them congruent by which test? By which test? Just see A, and this is common side, S. So, both these triangles are congruent by SAA test. So, in converse, it is congruent by SAA test or AAS test. Then you will take CSCT. You will say that if these two triangles are congruent by SAA test, therefore DE is congruent to DF. Therefore, DE will be congruent to DF, and reason is CSCT. So, this way, by simple proof, you can prove isosceles triangle theorem as well as converse of isosceles triangle theorem. I hope you understood. Okay. So, if the sides are congruent is given, you will write isosceles triangle theorem. If the angles are congruent is given, you will write converse of isosceles triangle theorem. Okay. Converse of isosceles triangle theorem. So, this way, I hope you will remember both the theorem properties. Okay, and go through the proof. No need to write in your book, just keep in your mind. Depending upon this, we will solve the practice set and the other theorems. I hope you understood, students. Thank you and take care. Bye.